6.6 magnitude earthquake generated that tsunami. Not only that, there's been earthquake swarms of nothing but aftershocks, and those aftershocks are right there by Taupo SuperVolcano. We got a lot to talk about. Let's do this. As we're bringing up some updates on what has taken place over the tsunami that happened after the 5.6 earthquake that actually took place, let's go ahead and get some information on what's going on in New Zealand. New Zealanders that are on the channel, I my heart goes out to you, and I just really pray that all of you guys are safe. I have been away from here, back and forth, and just came back to the computer actually looking at the volcanoes and earthquakes, and I saw this and I was devastated. Water surge damages boats after doozy of an earthquake under Lake Taupo. An overnight surge of water from an earthquake in Taupo left a telltale line of debris and sunken pedal boats in its wake. The 5.6 earthquake struck 15 kilometers southwest of the lakeside town at a depth of 5 kilometers. Aftershocks measuring 2.5 to 3.9 have followed the initial shake at 11:47 p.m. on Wednesday. A series of waves on the lake, described as mini tsunamis, wrecked two of the Taupo pedal boat vessels, which was not a great start to their summer season. Quake-induced wave clusters pulled the pedal boats off the beach and dashed them on the rocks at the Wairawaka near Four Mile Bay, and Jess Ratana, who owns the business, with Kirapiti Bowden. So there has definitely the boats just wrecked. It's showing it right there. It was bizarre. I've been living in Taupo all my life, and we have had lots of quakes before, but not like this, Ratana said. We got a call at 6 a.m. saying some of our boats were on the rocks and had been badly damaged. I was really surprised because we had pulled the boats further up the beach when that storm came through. You could see a line of debris about 12 p.m. up on the beach. Out on the lake were all our boats. Ratana said that we're still open for business, and their four water bikes and stand-up pedal boats were not damaged, but the two popular pedal boats were write-offs. Oh my, they are so battered. Insurance will cover the boats, but not the loss of income, and we will have to import our boats from overseas. By the time they are here, it will be too late for the year. It's gutting. She said her and her partner were woken up by the initial big quake and had a restless night at the aftershocks rolled through. It was out of the ordinary, and it was a long night. I was lying there thinking I couldn't hear anything being smashed in the house and was pretty happy about that. Then we got the call that we now down two boats. It's not a great start to the season at all. This is just heartening. Unbelievable. That looks like a crack in the road. The ground. That is unbelievable. I'm not going to read all the rest. Just want to let you know that this couple here had quite a few things that were destroyed. Their boats were. Thousands felt shake. Taupo had a strong shake with several aftershocks this evening. GeoNet wrote on Twitter overnight, adding that thousands of people had felt the moderate quake. Earthquakes are common for this area at volcano alert level 1. A map on the GeoNet website showed there were 5,440 reports of shaking, and that the quake was felt as far north as Whangarei and as far south as Christchurch. GNS seismic duty officer John Ristall said that the increased number of earthquakes are similar to other periods of quake clusters recorded in 2008 to 2009 and 2019. However, last night's earthquake was the largest in the current sequence. This is how saturated those earthquakes are. This is why I always keep a week's worth of earthquakes so you can actually see how hard these places are being hit. The Taupo caldera volcano lies under the lake, and this earthquake and its aftershocks are not an indicator that the volcano is waking up now or that an eruption is on the way. Taupo volcano is still active, although it hasn't erupted for hundreds of years. He said that Taupo volcano is currently at activity level 1. That's where you see it's yellow on the map. It is at level 1. The last earthquake with similar magnitude was in September 2019 with a similar aftershock sequence. People woken by the shaking shared their experiences on social media with some from Napier, Palmerston North, and other areas reporting feeling the quake and aftershocks. We're going to take a look and see what's going on Twitter as well. Lake Taupo had a strong shake with several aftershocks this evening. A shallow 5.3 was felt widely by 5,000 people at 11:47 p.m. Earthquakes are common for this area at the Val 1. Remember, if you're in bed when an earthquake occurs, stay, cover, and hold. So that was something that was there. So they don't feel that this is actually going to cause an eruption, but still, everybody, just make sure you have a way to listen to emergency broadcasts. And we're going to take a look at the map. We're going to take a look at everything. Now, when we look at the map, earthquake clusters all on Taupo volcano right now. Now, this is a 5.6 that occurred yesterday. And after then, these are the aftershocks that are going on. Let's take a look at the aftershocks. I do know that most of these are in the 2s and also in the 3s. There are a couple of 4.1s that I saw in this area. 2.1. I mean, it's just so many. It's just a major earthquake cluster all throughout this whole entire region. Look at this. And it goes all the way up. And it's very saturated in this particular area here. And very saturated in this particular area here. And if a lot of people aren't aware of it, this particular area has been deforming for some time now. This lake has been rising. This is something they've been monitoring since May. On the average, this area normally has around 20 earthquakes per week, but now this has actually superseded it, and especially with the actual aftershocks that are going on. And we're going to take a look at that too, because that's going to be ongoing for a while. Here are the aftershocks from the 5.6 earthquake that happened yesterday. Currently, the report on the aftershocks are aftershocks 200 largest out of the 202 total so far. So actually, there has been 202 aftershocks in Lake Taupo since that 5.6 earthquake. Now let's get a feel for how strong these aftershocks actually are, because some of them may not even be showing. It looked like there's so many. I see a 4.5 that happened, says one day, 12 hours ago. Let's go ahead and make sure that this is actually at the top. Here we go, because it's always out of order. 7 hours ago, there was a 3.9, 3.6 around 15 hours ago, 17, and then it goes on to like one day. So a lot of these earthquakes are in the 3s, and they're 4.5 here, 3.9. A lot of these are pretty strong, and then it wasn't that strong in the very beginning, but it seemed like they're actually getting stronger, because now we're getting down to the 2s, and this was a while ago. But if we go all the way back up, the most recent earthquakes are pretty strong compared to beginning. Well, no, they're not. They're actually 2s. The 3s were in this other area here. So there we go. There we go. There's the 3s there. So basically, it's in the 2s right now. There's a 3.9 there that happened 7 hours ago. 2.8 that happened 7 hours ago. 2.6 5 hours ago. And the last one that happened was a 2.1. Now, some of these earthquakes, it's going to take a while for them to actually record here on the aftershock page. What I'll do is I'll make sure that I put this link in the description so everyone can keep up with the aftershocks that are actually going on out there. Let's go ahead and take a look at some other resources on the event. Okay, this is very important. This is for the people that live in Lake Taupo, in the Taupo area. This particular website, stuff.co.nz, I'm not authorized to go to it, but they're talking about scientists believe powerful magmatic forces drove the tectonic movement that shook residents from their beds overnight. So they're saying that it's actually due to the magma moving and the tectonic plates out there. But when I click this website to try to bring the information to you on the video, you do not have permission to access this particular website. And it said the title of it is Magma Role in Big Shake Under Lake Taupo. So this may be more important than what I can find out, but you should be able to find something out. Once again, it's the stuff.co.nz website. It has more information on it because as I scour the news, for some reason, it's very hard to find anything on it, just very few articles. I will look again and see on Google and see if I can find something. We're gonna keep looking into this. You won't believe this, it's very hard to find anything. Here we go, maybe this is something. No, this isn't about the volcano. It's very hard. You know what? I know a lot of my New Zealanders always state that this is hard for them to find things out. Guess what? Now it's the opposite. Now it's hard for me to find things out about what's going on with you. Isn't that something? I've been so overprotective over you guys. One second. Okay, New Zealand. It looked like a lot of things are being shut out right now. I don't know what's going on between, you know, we are in different countries, and for some reason there's some things that I can't get any access to, and there seems like there's some social media type things going on right now. I won't get into it, but you probably already know, and I hope you are able to see this video. But what I'll do is I will check on this on the hour, and also I'll put up a warning thing to where I can hear if something else develops in this. But make sure you like, share, and subscribe. And I really apologize, I wasn't able to get back to the computer until just now, and I'll get this video out as soon as possible. And since we all, those of you that do converse with me in the comments, feel free to put some comments down. Let me know how you're doing, and let me know if you felt anything. And like I said, I really hope that you're able to get through to me from where you live. Now, you did have a tsunami, and we'll keep a look out, you know, we'll look, you know, into that as well to see if I, you know, if I can find out that information. Well, you've had problems finding out information, and now I'm starting to have problems finding out information for you. So, and I think some of you know exactly what I'm talking about. But we'll keep in contact, and please be safe. Make sure you have some sort of emergency app on you. Make sure you listen to your emergency broadcast. Have a way to have access to that. I hope there's horns or some sort of alarms or something out there also to get people's attention. But like, share, and subscribe, and we will see you guys in the next video. Ciao.